Hello from Chem Help ASAP. We're going to learn how to flip cyclohexane chairs. Now, if you're watching this playlist in a sequence, we saw in the previous video how to draw a chair, but now we're going to talk about this as how we flip a chair. And when we talk about flipping chairs, we're talking about changing conformations. This is a playlist about conformational analysis, after all. So, to review what we saw in a previous video, key ideas for each particular carbon in our molecule. So, this carbon here has two groups on it. They're both hydrogens. Point number one, one group is axial. So here is our vertical group. This is our axial hydrogen. And the other one's equatorial, the one that's has a more flat orientation is equatorial. Furthermore, each group can be classified as either up or down. This axial group, the bond points down, so this is down. And the equatorial group, it's a gentle up, but that is pointed up. Now I'm going to put a star by this one, and let's put an X by that one. Now let's do our flip. When we flip a chair, we don't flip this thing upside down. We actually change the conformation. And what goes on is the carbon on one end, if it's pointing down, and this is kind of pointing down with these bonds, it's going to get bent upward. And the carbon on the other end, which is kind of pointing up with these bonds, it's going to get bent downwards. And these bonds in the middle are also going to change their orientation some. So there's no substitute. We just got to draw this thing. So here is what our new chair is going to look like. So let's number our carbons. Always a good idea. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And so this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And let's fill in our hydrogens. And let's focus on 4 since we kind of focused on 4 before. So this carbon now has 2 hydrogens on it. The axial, this hydrogen, the one that was equatorial, now becomes axial. And so it's equatorial up, it is now axial up. And let's label that with the X, because that's what we labeled it with before. What happened to our hydrogen that was axial down? Well, it's still down, so it's oriented down, but it's now equatorial down. So the up and down, when you flip a chair, the groups don't change up and down, but they do reverse axial and equatorial. Now let's go ahead and fill in our other hydrogens. This particular hydrogen, it was axial up. It will now be up, but it's now equatorial up in that orientation. And this particular hydrogen off of carbon 3, it was equatorial down. It is now axial down. And that is too close to that carbon. Sometimes your pictures don't come out perfectly. Okay, on carbon 5, very similarly, this particular hydrogen, it is axial up. It will now be equatorial up, and this hydrogen is equatorial down. It's still down, but now it's axial down. I'm going to go ahead and go around and fill in all the other hydrogens. Axial and equatorial get switched. Up and down do not change in a flip. So this is a change in the conformation. Energetically, whether it looks exactly like this or not, we are in some manner going through some high energy state. So we have one chair over here, it's low in energy, and here's another chair, and then there's some high energy state in between, and there could be multiple high energy states, but this is a change in conformation. We're not rotating the molecule, we are actually flexing these bonds, and so we're putting the molecule through a high energy state. So this is what it means to flip a chair. The key idea, a group starts axial, when the chair flips, it will become equatorial. If a group is up in the original chair, it will continue to be up in the next chair. Up and down do not change, axial and equatorial do.